Hello everyone, my name is Manoj Sai from MATLAB Helper. In our day-to-day life, we send and receive so many messages or information. Now, we are going to implement data transmission in a secure way using symmetric key cryptography by writing a simple code in MATLAB. So, let's get started into our video. Before going further, we will learn about some basic concepts about symmetric key cryptography. Let us consider a sender who wishes to send a message, that is plain text. Before sending the plain text, we will encrypt the data using a secret key. This process is called encryption, and the resulting encrypted data is called ciphertext. This ciphertext is now transmitted to your receiver. Remember, this key which was used for encryption should be shared only with the receiver. We can relate this key as equal as our home key. Whoever have the access of key can enter into the home. So this key should be kept confidential. Now the receiver will receive the ciphertext. Using the secret key, he should decrypt the ciphertext to retrieve the plaintext back. This is how the symmetric key crypto system works. Here, the encryption algorithm can be anything. Even though there are some standard algorithms, today we will use a simple encryption algorithm, which will use Fibonacci series. In encryption algorithm, we will generate a Fibonacci series of alphabets starting after from the given key. If the given key is K, then the series will be L, M, N, P, S and so on, which will actually follow the Fibonacci series 1, 2, 3, 5, 8 and so on. Next step is to add the plain text, which will be an array of characters with the generated Fibonacci series of alphabets. Remember, we should generate the Fibonacci series of length equal to the plain text because the dimension should match for adding two matrices. This addition will give us an array of integers. This array is our cipher. These integers are nothing but ASCII codes of characters. Now, coming to the decryption algorithm, always the decryption will be the exact reverse process of the encryption. So, this is the encryption algorithm. Now, the reverse process of this is plain text is equal to cipher minus generated Fibonacci array. So, the overall process can be visualized like this given example. Let us consider a sender who wishes to send a plain text, that is MATLAB. By using a key K, he will encrypt the MATLAB into the ciphertext. Now this ciphertext is transmitted to a receiver. Now the receiver will decrypt the ciphertext using the key K and he will get the MATLAB back. Now getting into the code, since Fibonacci series is used by sender and receiver, I created a Fibonacci function which will generate Fibonacci series of length specified by an input argument L. First initializing x of 1 and x of 2 by 1 and 2 respectively, because first two elements will be 1 and 2 in a Fibonacci series. A for loop from 3 to L will add the previous two array elements. This is Fibonacci series function. If the given plaintext is a single alphabet, then there is no need for the second array element. So in the Fibonacci series should also contain a single number, that is 1. Now let us see the sender side code. In the first step, we will take plain text and key as an input from the user. In the second step, we will calculate the length of plain text and passing it into the Fibonacci function. The generated Fibonacci series will be stored in FRA. In the third step, we will add FRA and key. It will generate the ASCII codes of Fibonacci series of alphabets starting after from the given key. This is stored in fib underscore array. Finally, by adding fib array and ptext, we will get ciphertext array. In the fourth step, we will open a text file called cipher.txt using fopen function. We will write the cipher into this file, so we will give specification as w. Next, fprintf is used for writing the cipher into the file. Since cipher is an array of integers, we will give format specification as %d. Finally, fclosure for closing the file. In the fifth step, we will print a confirmation message on screen using fprintf. Now we will see the receiver side code. So the receiver side code will contain, in the first step we will open the text file which was shared by sender using fopen function. we will read the file into the cipher array. So we will give the specification as R. Next, the file is containing a series of integer, so the format specification is percentile d. Receiver will don't know the actual size of the cipher array, so one row and infinite column. Fscanf is used for scanning the file into the cipher. Fclose is for closing the file. In the second step, we will calculate the length of cipher array and passing it into the Fibonacci function. The generated Fibonacci series will be stored in FArray. In the third step, take key as input from user. Now adding key with FArray will generate Fibonacci series of alphabet starting from the given key. This series is stored into fib underscore array. In the fourth step, subtracting the fib array from cipher will give us plain text back. Finally, we will print the plain text transmitted by the sender on screen using fprintf. Let us start running the code. For that, we will run sender side code first. Enter a plain text. Let us say MATLAB helper. Enter a key, say C. Cipher is generated and copied into cipher.txt file. Now we will see the cipher.txt file. It is containing some integer array. This is our ciphertext. Now we will clear the workspace. Now we will run the receiver side code. Enter the key, that is C. The plaintext transmitted by the sender is MATLAB helper. We got our plaintext back. Now we will try for a wrong key. For that we should run the receiver code once again. Enter the key. Now we will give another key. Let us say K. Plain text transmitted by the sender is something which is not the MATLAB helper. So if we give the wrong key, we cannot retrieve the plain text back. Now we will give the correct key, that is C. So we got the MATLAB helper back. Thus we successfully implemented the symmetric key cryptography in MATLAB. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any query, post it in the comments or get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future, MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing!